We'll continue in this video by meshing the point cloud that we edited in the previous video. In order to follow the workflow and obtain the same results as the video, we'll use the file portscan2. We can download this file from the learning management system or directly from Verisurf using the URL shown here. The file should be unzipped in our download directory. Let's choose the measure manager and hide the device manager so we have more room on the screen. We'll then choose the reverse manager. In this workflow, we'll filter the point cloud to a uniform separation, create a 3D mesh, and apply smoothing. We'll also fill any holes and then crop the ends to create uniform boundaries. We'll start by filtering the point cloud. Let's right-click the cloud and choose Tools, Filter. We'll use a 0.025 minimum distance and enable averaging. If we're testing various settings, we can save the filtered cloud as a copy. We'll then choose Filter and Close. Let's rotate the cloud to observe the uniform point distribution. If we notice any outliers, we should remove them before proceeding. Next, we'll create a mesh. Let's right-click the cloud and choose Tools, 3D Mesh. Note that we could have filtered the points while meshing rather than beforehand. This would simplify the comparison of multiple meshes using various filter distances. We'll accept the default mesh parameter values shown here and choose Create. Let's highlight the mesh and view the result. If we display face edges, we can see the pattern of triangles. There's a hole where the valve guide passes through the port and an irregularity on the side. We'll address these in a later step. The mesh was created with probe center data, but we want the mesh to represent the surface tangent to the probe, so we'll offset the mesh outward by the probe radius. Let's right-click the mesh and choose Tools, Offset. We'll change the amount to 0.1854, the probe radius, enable Create Copy, choose Offset, and Close. Let's highlight both meshes and view the results. If the offset mesh looks correct, we can delete the original mesh. Next, we'll close the holes in the mesh and produce a more uniform set of triangles. Let's right-click the mesh and choose Mesh Utilities, Power Mesh. This function allows us to clean up, refine, smooth, and close an existing mesh with a single click. We'll select an intermediate mesh density of 8, and we'll enable Close Boundary to fill the hole and close the ends. We'll then choose OK. The result is a new, closed mesh with a more uniform pattern of triangles. We can see the effect as we rotate the view. If we hide the face edges, we see a few small depressions in the mesh. Let's right-click the mesh and choose Tools, Smooth. We'll choose a low smoothing factor, around 0.1, and enable Create Copy so we can compare the results. We'll then choose Smooth and Close. Comparing the two meshes shows an improvement in smoothness without changing the shape of the mesh. Let's rename the result Mesh 1 and delete the other two. We'll complete the mesh by trimming the ends to create flat boundaries. Let's start in right G view and unzoom 80%. We'll then right-click the mesh and choose Tools, Crop. The blue crop box shows the extents of the mesh along the X, Y, and Z axes. We'll start by rotating the box -7 degrees around X to line it up with the left end of the mesh. We'll then drag the slider to move the crop plane to the end of the mesh. We'll use an exact value of -3.75 to provide repeatable results if we're following the workflow. Finally, we'll choose Crop. Let's rotate the box around X to -66 to align the crop plane with the right end of the mesh. If we change view to the right end, we see that we also need a -5 degree rotation around the Y axis. We'll then choose a positive Y value of 0.83. and choose Crop. Finally, we'll close the dialog and choose right G view to see the results. The mesh is now ready for surfacing, which we'll perform using both lofting and quick surface in subsequent videos. Let's save the file. To see the difference, visit us at verisurf.com.